Okay, so we're going to be celebrating Jen's 40th birthday, and we want to surprise him with some stories. So what kind of things do you think we can embarrass him with?
Let's see. Okay. There's so many.
I think James is beyond being embarrassed any longer. He's heard all of our stories.
That's true.
His friends have it.
That's true. That's true.
Well, there's a bunch of them, I'll tell you.
Okay. How about the garage story, Dad? That's a good one to start with.
That is a good price.
Yeah.
You mean when he always liked to steal all the tools?
Yeah, but how was he getting in that garage? After how many attempts of trying to figure out what it was, what was he actually...
Well, we finally put locks on all the garage doors because James would get the tools and spread them all over the vacant lot. Including your grandpa Larry's tools.
Oh.
That would be bad to mess with.
For some of those, he didn't always put in the lot. Sometimes he saved them to wrap them up in toilet paper and stuff them down the toilet.
Oh, God.
So in the garage toilet?
Which used, no.
In the house toilet?
In the back bedroom.
Oh, my God.
Which used to frustrate Grandpa Larry to the very end of his life. James. Anyway, Grandpa Lincoln one time found two screwdrivers, two pliers, and a small hammer. And James had shoved down the drain in the toilet. Grandpa had to lift up the seal to the toilet, take the whole thing out of the floor just to get his tools back. But otherwise, Jim used to like to get tools out of the garage, and as you know, we had a vacant lot next door to us, and we would find tools all over the lot. Well, I got sick and tired of it because, you know, you can only buy tools so many times and it gets to be a bore. So we locked all the garage doors so James could no longer get into the garage. But it seemed, nevertheless, I'd continue to miss tools. Well, one day I was out in the back working on the roses, the little rose garden we had there in the back.
Yeah.
And there was a half bath in that garage for the gardener. So I went to wash my hands and do whatever else you do in a half bath. And I closed the door. And lo and behold, as I closed the door, behind the door, which normally opened, there was a big hole where James could crawl into the garage. And that's the way he was getting all the tools out. So we had to, of course, put some boards in there and so forth. Well, I'll tell you. I'm sure you all have your stories about James, so go ahead and rotate yourselves.
Yeah, well, the other things he probably had in there that, you know, are so mild in comparison to what you find now, but the Sears bra catalogs and things like that. Woo!
Yeah, Jim was always a tip man.
Remember that little wheel, big wheel brigade? All the boys in the neighborhood all had their big wheels, and he rubbed his down all the way to the, just, there were no tires left anymore.
He would ride it off the lawn.
Oh,
like onto the sidewalk.
Drop.
Onto the sidewalk. Kind of get a little beating, and then just keep on going. He was a little motorboat. He never stopped. Never stopped.
Remember when he would jump off the balcony?
Oh, my God. There'd just be deep footprints, and then he would take off. You'd never know.
But. He thought he was a $6 million man. Or how about when he put the cat on the grill?
I was just going to say that. Remember he had white fur all over his mouth? And he said, what happened? Nothing.
Was
he was all scratched up and everything. The cat's name was Mouse. He bit it. The cat bit him, so he bit the cat, and then he threw it off the balcony after he put it on the grill.
And he had scratches all up and down his arms.
Uh-huh. The cat
what?
Not happy. I don't know what you're talking about.
Why did this?
How about when we got he and Jim, John Tammany to dress up like girls for Halloween.
Jimelina.
They had the matching dresses that we had when we were kids, and they were running through the neighborhood for Halloween.
And when he was older, we dressed him up again. He wore a leotard.
Oh, how about that? He was really little, and we got him to get into the dollhouse, in the doll.
Oh, he was in the high chair.
And he's
trying to get
out. I was so mad. She couldn't find the tools to get him out.
We had to take him apart.
Because Jim had lost him, though.
Yeah, we thought we could put him in there and make him our little doll.
No, I remember he used to take everything apart. So
everything.
Something was happening with the phone. And the next thing you knew, it was sitting in his room with everything off, every little piece all over the bed. Oh, I'm gonna fix it. It's all good. And it was never put back together.
I can do it.
Oh my gosh. What other kind of things did he do? Oh, remember trying to get him up for school?
He'd have to flip his mattress over. We'd pour cold water on him. We had a water gun with cold water in it. We'd shoot that at him and he wouldn't get
up. But he was always on time for work.
Yeah, because he cared then. He didn't care. It didn't matter. I wasn't important yet. I know.
His first little birthday cake. Icing all over his face.
Yeah.
He was very cute.
And his adorable.
He had that cute
cut.
Little blonde haircut. His little haircut was so cute. We picked him out.
He's so cute.
He's so cute.
That's when he was little.
Yeah, he was adorable.
Later on, I was afraid he was going to go to prison for life.
He used to say that we should sleep with one eye open. What are you talking about? I sleep with one eye open.
Yeah, I remember for his 20th sober birthday, he had written me a letter when I was in Arizona going to school, and he was in rehab, and I saved that letter.
Oh, did you?
And I went to show it to him for his 20th, and I kind of thought I would just show it to him and take it back. And he's like, oh, and he took it. And I guess he still has it. So
he probably does.
Yeah. It was sweet. So
Jim hangs on to things. He enjoys his sisters. He's enjoyed, the things that he's accomplished in life, because your brother, he didn't really have an easy road, but he overcome. Boy, what a father and husband, son and brother he is now, huh?
Yeah, he's incredible. Yeah. The one thing I love about being with Jimmy is that
it's never dull.
I am on a natural high when I'm with him all the time. I mean, he makes me laugh hysterically.
Because he's just 100 miles an hour.
And he just says whatever he thinks.
I know.
Yeah,
no,
like
buffer.
My kids know. It's like he's 6 or something, and, he says whatever's on his mind.
Like,
we're out boating. What was it when we were in Big Bear?
Oh,
we're out boating. He says, oh, God, the kids can say it so much better than me. They get such a kick out of it because he's like, the canoers all of a sudden were just like magnets to his boat. He's like, oh yeah, see, canoeing isn't as easy as you think it is it? Maybe you should move out of the way. What is wrong with you people? Do you guys not know how to even do anything? What is your problem? You don't know how to steer?
Oh, no, speaking to
Spanish,
he's
stares
the boat.
He's a perfectionist with everything that he has. He keeps everything perfect.
He's a very rare personality. I mean, he really is a rare personality. He can take...
No, that would be funny.
People he's never seen before, never met before, and he can act like he's known him for 20 years and have him laughing or giggling or carrying on about things that they could care less about, except Jim is there. He makes the world go around.
Tell the story about the binoculars with the Tammies at the football
game. Those are terrible stories, Jennifer.
But true.
Well, the rest of the Tammies were here tonight. They'd appreciate this one. Pete Tammy and his son, of course, John, and James and I decided to go to a football game at the Rose Bowl. I forget who was playing it, it doesn't matter, but so we had Tammy's as our guest. And before we left, I said, Jim, get our binoculars. I said, we got to have some binoculars for the game. And I'll be darned if I could find our binoculars. So anyway, Jim turns up for the pair. So we go to the game. And we're sitting there watching the game, having a nice time. And I noticed Mr. Tammy's kind of looking at these binoculars, like maybe they're familiar to him. Well, it turns out when Jim was in one of his supers, long before, because he was quite sober now, he had stolen from his Tammy's and had forgotten that they were that they belonged to them. So when he took them to the game, everything was cool, you know. He also had their, what was that? They used to have Walkman.
Oh, yeah.
And the Walkman TVs.
Walkman. Yeah.
He had all the time his Walkmans. But I always blamed Pete, you know. I said, Pete, you know, it's really all your fault. Because you always kept all that booze in your garage to have all those fantastic parties. And you might have known that Jim would be the one person that would know how to get in and have his own party anytime he wanted to.
That is true.
Of course, if he didn't have you, he always had the little store at the corner. What was the name of that
Jorgensen's.
Store?
Jorgensen's.
He just put it on the charger.
No, he didn't put it on the charger. He put the sandwich on his charge. He put the booze in his jacket. Gosh darn.
So should we give him a birthday wish? Say something in particular about his birthday that we want to share?
Yeah, you guys go ahead. I'll give you one at the end.
Well, I can't believe you're 40. You're old now.
I know. Join the club.
Welcome
join
to our
club.
Decade,
exactly.
Brother. We love you a lot.
We love you. You're the best.
Yeah. You are the best.
Yeah.
You're a wonderful dad. A wonderful brother. Yep, we love you.
You grew up just amazing. Mom and Dad did a good job, and you were a little shit.
I want all my radios and my bikes back that you stole to you stole and gave to our neighbors.
And we gotcha because I'm here.
I know.
Yep.
Surprise!
We love you.
Love
now,
you.
Thank God, Heather, you married him.
Anybody
else would have killed him by now. But you know, Jim, I'll say this much for you. If you can give us all, I'm going to try. If you can give us for the next 40 years what you've given us for the last 40, God bless you. You're the best.
There you are. Love you guys.
Love you.
Great family.
Happy birthday.
We're so blessed to have you.
Bye-bye, son.